Tonight, we have new details about Maria Butina's time here in the United States. Butina is the gun rights activist who was arrested last year just before she planned to leave the country and is accused of acting as an agent for the Russians. CNN's Brian Todd has spoken to a woman who knows Butina. Brian, what are you learning?
Wolf, we've gotten an exclusive interview with this woman, Elena Nicolaou, who says she and her family went to Disney World with Maria Butina and her boyfriend, Paul Erickson, in 2015. The family took the couple in as friends, and now, she says, they are left with many questions.
It's a view of Maria Butina, the 30-year-old accused of being a spy for Russia, previously never seen. Instead of carrying a gun, she's playfully pointing to a Moscow sign at Disney World. The pictures, along with several others, were taken by journalist Elena Nicolaou, who befriended Butina in 2015. The two women met, she says, through Republican operative Paul Erickson, who went to Yale with Nicolaou's mother and who was secretly dating the much younger Russian. Erickson and Butina shared a mutual interest in guns.
He made her laugh, and she tended to be on the serious side.
Nicolaou and her parents took a trip to Disney World with Butina and Erickson in 2015, a three-day excursion that Nicolaou says captivated the young Russian.
We swam with dolphins. Maria's favorite ride ever was Space Mountain. Right after Space Mountain, she paused and she looked at my sister and me and she said, "That was the most fun I've ever had in my life." And in those instants, she seemed like a kid.
But prosecutors say she was not a kid. In December, Maria Butina pleaded guilty to conspiracy to being an unlawful, unregistered agent for a foreign government. Prosecutors say Butina infiltrated groups like the National Rifle Association to network with Republicans. But in an exclusive television interview with CNN, Elena Nicolaou says that back in 2015, Butina came across as a fun-loving 20-something with a fondness for all things Disney. These pictures, Nicolaou says, were sent to her family by Erickson, of Butina and Erickson on a Disney cruise before that Disney World trip, the two of them wearing pirate outfits and Beauty and the Beast costumes.
I think that was sort of their, like, relationship icon, Beauty and the Beast, because she was very beautiful.
Beauty and the Beast.
Butina's Beauty and the Beast affinity reflected in a recorded duet she sang with Erickson in Russia. But Nicolaou says even during that Disney trip, Butina displayed some mysterious behavior, like missing a whole day of activities after claiming she'd chipped a tooth.
She may have done something to her tooth, or maybe she was gone for different reasons, but I don't know.
Nicolaou, who wrote about her experiences with Butina in the online publication Refinery 29, says Butina and Erickson made splashy entrances at two parties at Nicolaou's parents' house, Erickson once dressing in a toga. And in one bizarre moment, the future accused Russian spy read Nicolaou's palm.
I remember giving her my hand, and she looked at it and looked at me very seriously, and she goes, you know, I'm 21, I think, at this moment. She goes, "You will definitely cheat on your husband, 100% cheater." And I was really taken aback.
Nicolaou says Butina at the time was open about her interests in advocating for gun rights in Russia and working closely in the United States with leaders of the NRA. Looking back, Nicolaou says she didn't suspect Butina was a spy.
I wasn't surprised when I read all of the allegations because those were what she was open about, that those are what she was saying she was doing. So I'm not sure if she's a spy.
A former Justice Department counterintelligence attorney says Butina's interactions with Nicolaou might have been part of a plan to blend in.
Just because her activities were out in the open doesn't mean that she wasn't doing them at the behest of the Russian government or Russian intelligence.
Now, as for Paul Erickson, Nicolaou calls him a con man. Erickson was indicted last week on fraud charges. Elena Nicolaou says he duped her parents out of money. We reached out to Paul Erickson and his attorneys to respond to that. We got no response from them, but Erickson's attorney in South Dakota had previously said about his indictment for fraud that Erickson's side believes a different story from the government's is going to emerge. Maria Butina's attorney told us he had no comment on Elena Nicolaou's accounts about Butina.